My daughter Jennifer worked at the feedlots when she was going to school in the summer and worked on the processing crew. And one June, I recall, she came home, and I hadn't been in the house when she walked in about 3:30, and I don't believe I had ever seen one person with that much cow manure on their body and still be ambulatory. I mean, it looked like a flock of cows had flown over her. And I said, "My gosh, what happened?" Well, she said, we been working cattle all morning, processing them, and we got all the cattle done that they'd brought up, so we went to lunch, and the cattle foreman saw us back there, and he said, "My gosh, you think you're done, do you?" Well, he got us something to do that afternoon. He sent a couple of cowboys out this big pasture east of the feedlot, and it had been raining a lot that June, and of course that meant in Colorado you continued to irrigate, so this was a lush pasture, and the calves, or I say calves, they probably weighed 5 or 6, that had been out on that grass, you know, they really looked good. They were soggy, is the term. They kind of rolled when they walked, you know, had a lot of bloom. They were definitely not dehydrated. And they started running these calves through the squeeze chute, and, well, you can imagine. And so I always think of her when I do this poem. When the crew came toward the cookhouse, Hazel shut and locked the door. "Don't you even think about it. Looks like y'all been in a war." And though Hazel didn't know it, she was not that far off track. They'd been working pasture cattle, and them critters could fight back. All that grass that they'd been eating lubricated their insides. Plus, those cows were full as dog ticks, and a little loose besides. So when squeezed in some tight corner, they could aim their guns at will and bombard that crew of cowboys with recycled chlorophyll. Now, it's only grass and water, as you'll hear the pundits say, but I'm here to tell you, partners, their performance on that day was a duck-and-run Olympics, a projectile Super Bowl, a team of Dutch boys at the dike who couldn't find the hole. Willie got hit when his hot shot caught a big one by surprise. With one long blast, she turned him into split pea soup with eyes. Big Sam looked like a seaweed when his beard took several shots. And Pedro's fancy brand-new hat got covered with the trots. A broadside fired from point-blank range went down O'Malley's shirt. He emptied out the vaccine gun, and she matched him squirt for squirt. And then Frank got trapped behind a gate and watched with some concern while the bunch backed up and measured him, and each one took a turn. It was hanging off their hat brim. It was dripping off their clothes. It was in their eyes and in their ears and probably up their nose. Not a cowboy went untainted. Not a dog escaped the muck. Not a standing stick, a saddle horse, a whip or chute or truck was immune to their propellant. They looked like works of art, little guacamole statuettes, or cow pies a la carte. Hazel backed him to the spigot and stood beside the trough. "I can't clean up your cowboy ways, but I'll hose the outside off." Sam was looking at O'Malley. "Is that what they really mean, when an Irish cowboy celebrates the wearing of the green?" "I don't think so," said O'Malley. "But when I see cows eat grass, I'll forever be reminded of that phrase, 'This too shall pass.'"